next up, in terms of compatibility, how do Taurus and Capricorn get along romantically?
Well, Taurus is another earth sign like Capricorn. One of the number of things that they do have in common is earth signs are practical. They are down to earth. They share a lot of common philosophy. So they value security. They don't turn their noses up to earning money. They value home. Whereas some of the air signs or fire signs might be more inclined to spend their time in large social groups and adventurous gatherings, Taurus and Capricorn might enjoy spending time maybe with friends in smaller groups and maybe entertaining in the home. Gotcha. So they are more about home and heart, and they are definitely both signs where loyalty and security really maximize affection.
Gotcha. And the way you're talking about it, I kind of get a sense of intimacy, not necessarily in a sexual way, but just in general, like an appreciation for intimacy within both of them.
That is a really good word, appreciation for intimacy, and that you're also bringing up that it provides the security that both need. Capricorn does need to be admired for all the wonderful things that Capricorn does over the long haul, and Taurus is able to do that.
Okay. Appreciate each other.
Very cool. So it's a good pairing.
Sounds like it. So in general, what are some Capricorn specific traits and how that might play into their romantic relationships regardless of their sign?
So a Capricorn sun, this is a cardinal sign, an earth sign. Capricorns are noted for their capacity for perseverance, for hard work, for practicality, for determination, self-discipline, ambition. And in terms of relationships, when there is a sense of security and that there is potential for long-term stability, they are loyal and devoted partners.
Gotcha.
So that's just a little bit about the sun sign of Capricorn. And of course, we know that with regard to compatibility, we're just going to be discussing sun signs today. But in truth, your rising sign, your moon, Venus, and other planetary placements can be incredibly important in compatibility. But we're keeping it simple at general sun sign compatibilities today.
Gotcha, because that's one of the things I've learned from you. There's a lot of planets, a lot of stars, a lot going on in space, so there's a lot going on in
what
can
happen.
We have moving
parts, many moving parts.
Yeah, many moving parts, lots of influencing factors, and so this is just one of them that we're discussing, but it seems to be a strong one in our culture.
Sun is, it's the center of our system, our solar system, and our sun sign has so much to do with our inner self, our sense of purpose, and who we are at our innermost essence and being. So it's important to look at that.
That's a good way to think of it, too. The sun is the center, so no wonder it carries such weight. I didn't even have that perspective. That's it, because we don't have
good
to do
luck.
Scorpio and Sagittarius. Yes,
good luck.
Good luck and love, because you might need it. And I think something that's very important too. One of the biggest lessons I've ever learned in love, with regardless of the sign or anything, is when you can really figure out how to love yourself, it makes it that much easier to love anyone and anything else. So maybe that's where your luck will be.
You're giving me goosebumps. It's so true.
Yeah.
That's true.
So love yourself first.
Amen.